Very important announcement that on next Saturday, November 14th at noon, make sure if you have the money that you can join us. It's $25. All of the money is going to Toys for Tots. Claudine and I, Elvira from the Doll Circle, and myself are hosting a live Zoom doll chat. Three generations of doll collectors confess, where we are going to be sharing our thoughts about all the dolls that have happened this year, dolls from our past, what we hope for dolls for the future, and confessing some of our more things that we've done for dolls, about dolls, and it's going to be a good time. And then we're going to try to leave some time at the end for you guys to do some Q&A with us. So it's $25. All of that money goes to Toys for Tots. There is a link down below at the very top of everything in this description where you can purchase your ticket to come to the Zoom call next Saturday, November 14th at noon.
Hey, everybody. Welcome back to my world, where no matter how old you get, you never need to grow up. I bought a new sweater. So after my whole conversation with you guys in the video that posted yesterday about new clothes and stuff like that, I went to Target and I saw these really soft, snuggy sweaters, and I was like, screw it, I'm buying myself some new clothes. But they're all soft, snuggy sweaters, because what else are you gonna wear nowadays, right? And I posted something on my Instagram. I'm not sure how you voted yet, but I've been a bad girl. I've been shopping a lot the last 2 weeks online. And it's what I do. It's my stress reliever. I'm not advocating that as a coping habit, a coping mechanism, because, you know, it costs money. But and excessive consumerism and all of that. But so I've been shopping, and I've been looking at this on ColourPop for the longest time, ColourPop Cosmetics, and they have like a whole Sailor Moon set. Like, I totally missed out on the Hocus Pocus set. Their sets sell out so fast. But Sailor Moon was in stock, and so I got this, and this is what I chose for it. I'm not sure if you're gonna get the whole holographic situation on the cover here, which is very cool. And these are the colors in the Sailor Moon. So I did choose to go with this, and I'm wearing this. I'm wearing like several of them because they're not very deeply pigmented. So I'm wearing this light green thing, the purple one, and this one. I'm wearing all three of those to achieve this look, which looks predominantly purple. So I like it, but the colors are not as pigmented as they usually are in a ColourPop kit, but I'm thinking they were going more, or in a ColourPop eyeshadow palette, I'm thinking they were going more like watercolor-y look for Sailor Moon, so, but I'm happy with it. I'm happy with the way it came out. Now, hopefully my eyes don't react to it, because I just never know there's disgusting lipstick smeared all over my mug, because I should be drinking it this way so you don't see my disgusting lipstick smears. Which grossed out my son to no end. Okay, so today we are reviewing the first of the, I guess this is the second way of the LOL OMG Winter Chill dolls. This is a big wig, and I ordered three of the four because I didn't like one of them. So I ordered Missy Meow, I ordered Camp Cutie, and I ordered Big Wig. I did not order, what is it, Icy Girl? Icy Girl, because I didn't like the way she looked. I just wasn't digging the outfit, I wasn't feeling the look, and it's my money, so I'm not gonna spend it. I will put a link in the description to where you can get Big Wig and the rest of the Winter Chill dolls. They are on Amazon, they're available on walmart.com and target.com. I did actually venture out to a Target store yesterday, and I didn't see any of the new dolls. I was in search of Bella Parker, because as we unbox this doll, let's talk about, you know, because I'm all about talking about uncomfortable feelings lately. So so I got triggered this week, and I was that kid again in grammar school, middle school, who was ostracized and, you know, treated badly. you say, well, Melissa, mommy, how did that happen? What happened? Well, like, a whole bunch of YouTubers got sent the Bella Parker doll from MGA, and they also got sent these dolls, and I got nothing. And I went into this whole, like, shame spiral over it. And because I was like, you know, there was this whole, like, what am I not? Okay, so I need to, all right, so we need to slide this off. Let's do this right, right? I was like, this whole thing, like, I guess I'm not good enough. Does MGA not like me? Are they mad that I broke the hands on the Gaga Lake doll and the rock, you know, and the thing set? Like, I went through all these weird things because that's what happens when you go into, like, a shame spiral. And here's the deal. So I'm almost 53 now. I'm going to be 53 in less than a month. And I still experience shame spirals. Let's look at this beautiful girl, shall we? Oh, see, I was loving the artwork on this one. I'm not even loving the artwork on Icy Girl. I feel bad because I'm talking about shame spiral and I'm, like, shaming her. I'm just saying she's not my cup of tea, which is to say that, like, not everybody is going to like you. Not everybody is going to like me, and that's okay. So here's what I do. It's like, well, spinny. Oh, stand up and strut your stuff. So so first of all, let's talk about the doll before we go into how one deals with shame spiraling. I'm sorry, people are texting me. Do they not know that I am? So these dolls are $34.99. They're $34.99 on Amazon because they come with the big doll and the little sister as well. And so the way you're supposed to open them, well, let's read the back and then we'll get back to shame. OMG, we sisters are ready to slay the ultimate winter vacay. We're after chill vibes and space to create on an adventure that is snow outrageous. I'm feeling like the whole Punster High moment here. And then it's got that same thing in, like, a zillion different languages. There are 25 surprises inside. Believe me, parents, aunts, uncles, grandparents, cool people who buy dolls for kids or for themselves, you probably want these because we know that the quality on the LOL OMG dolls just keeps going up and up. And you may want all four of them. You may want Icy Girl and you may not want Big Wig. And that's all good, man. Nobody's judging you for that. We're not judging. We're in a judgment-free zone. And so is shame about judgment? Shame is about, it's about connection, loss of connection. But here's the thing. Here's how I deal with it. So I felt this. And at first I was angry. So, like, you go through these reactions, but I want you to notice something. What I do, because I'm older now and I've studied this a lot and I've been through a lot of therapy, is I feel it. And as soon as I feel it, I step back and start observing what I'm feeling. So instead of getting sucked into the vortex of the shame spiral, there's actually a part of me that becomes the observer, because that's who you really are. The observer is who you really are. The emotions and the thoughts are not the real you. That's just some stuff that's, like, you've got a bunch of memories and crap in your head and you know, neurotransmitters and stuff. But the real you is the part of you that can step back and observe this happening. And so I watched it happening. I was angry at MGA. I was like, I'm going to email them. I just was chosen by Toys R Us to do doll of the year. And they don't send me these dolls. Oh, I'm so angry. Okay. Beep. No, I'm not angry at MGA. Then I was feeling less than. I was looking at the people who got sent the dolls and, you know, going through all the reasons that they're better than I am and they're more deserving and they're worthy of being sent these dolls and I'm not worthy of being sent these dolls. And then I was like, no. Melissa probably had limited samples. You send them to the people who get the most views, who they feel represents the brand, the way they want the brand to be represented, blah, blah, blah. It's not personal. It's a professional choice. It has nothing to do about you as a person. It doesn't determine your self-worth. All right. So I go through all that and then I get deep down and I realize that the core of what I'm feeling is shame because I was feeling that the people who were sent the dolls, when they saw that I wasn't sent the dolls, were going to think less of me and that you guys were going to think less of me because other people were sent the dolls and I wasn't sent the dolls. And that brought me back to that little girl who was ostracized, pointed at, teased for being different and being separate. And shame is about losing connection. And so like the feeling was that I had lost my connection to you guys, that I would lose my connection to my friends who received the dolls. And when I did all of that observation, I was like, whatever, I'll buy Bella when she comes out. And I bought these dolls my damn self. So, and that, my friends, is how you deal with a shame spiral. You observe it. You feel it all. Don't tell yourself not to feel it. Oh, no. Never tell yourself not to feel something. Never judge your feelings. You look at your feelings, you observe your feelings, you feel your feelings. And then you move on to the next feeling and the next feeling and the next feeling. And you look at them and you say, what is true? What is true about what I'm feeling or what I'm thinking right now? And eventually, most of the time, you figure out that probably none of what you're thinking is true. And the feelings are causing these thoughts that are not true, but you feel the feelings, you move through it, you find the core, you get to the core, you look at the core and you say, is this true? And then you're like, no, you guys still love me. And my friends who got sent the dolls love me and they're not paying attention. Oh, and the most important thing in the whole world about all of this is no one is actually thinking about you. No one is thinking about you anywhere near as much as you think they're thinking about you. As a matter of fact, they probably haven't thought about you at all in the thing that you're feeling shame about. They have not even thought about it. Bam. Okay, so this is how you open the doll. And parents, feel free to process what I just said and then sit down and watch this part of this video with your kids and be like, I don't know how to explain this to you. Listen to this lady. She seems to know what she's talking about. So we're supposed to pull here. Ici. I speak French, sort of. I used to speak French. I don't speak French anymore, right? So I want to get this tag off. Pull! I'm pulling! There's tape. Is there tape? I was pulling the wrong way. Ta-da! I wonder why MGA doesn't send me the dog. Okay, so you pull it this way, and it reveals our girl. Here she is. Here is Big Wig. I am loving her hair. I'm loving her colors, because obviously I'm in a pink period right now in my life. Oh, you beautiful girl. And then on this side, so parents, the cool thing about this is, first of all, like so many of the LOL OMG dolls we've had recently, this whole thing becomes something that you can keep and keep as a playset. So this, when we take the doll out, you'll see this is a dressing room. On this side, we've got the surprises. Now this is taped. Yes, this is taped. And I didn't untape it before I started filming, and I'm not gonna edit this out. By the way, if you have not been watching Claudina Nine's videos of late, you need to do that because slaying it. Okay, so remember, guys, next Saturday, November 14th at noon, we're going to have a doll chat. You're going to get to talk to the Claudina Nine, who is amazing, and the Elvira from the Doll Circle, also amazing. Their videos have been killing it in quality. Their thoughts about dolls, they're very good friends of mine. I love them, and you just go watch them now. All links to their channels and all of their socials are down below. They're the best. So parents, anyway, back to this. So parents and people who buy this. Then we're supposed to open this up. Ta-da! Look at this. This is very cool. And there she is. She's cute. Now, I don't collect the original LOL dolls anymore, but she is very, very cute. And then we've got all of our surprises in here. So let's pull this out. And so what's cool, again, is that on this side, we have kind of like, I don't know, looks like a very like 1960s sort of hallway. Like, look at those cool chandeliers. And then, of course, on this side, we're going to see what's behind here in the dressing room. So let's look at our surprises and our little sis first. Oh, she's so cute. Madam Queen. Oh, the pink sparkles. I am getting such like
Oh, Legally Blonde. Oh my gosh. Elle from Legally Blonde would so love this outfit and this look. Look at her little pink, glittery, gorgeous hair and her little gloves. She's so Jackie O. Loving it. Loving the look. Look at the little shoes. Oh, she's adorable.
And she comes with her little sippy cup mason jar thing, which I'm not doing that whole thing. She spits and stuff. We don't care. I don't do that anymore. There you go. Sparkles, glitter to go with her. And let's see what else we got. We've got the clothes for our big wig. Our winter chill. And I'm loving that it's sweater weather again. Ha ha, sweater weather. Everybody who knows what the ha ha is on sweater weather. But I love it very much. It's like, it's we're in kind of my favorite time of year. I'm not a huge fan of winter, but I love fall. And I love me some snuggy sweaters. Okay, so let's see what's in our adorable hat box. This is a good hat box. This one might end up on my desk. I'm liking the stripes. Let's see what we got. Ooh. Uh-oh, tiny laptop. Oh, my. Oh, wow. This is like the world's... I don't even know. Wow. This is like the world's smallest collar and tie situation. Okay. Tiny laptop! Caden loves a tiny laptop. I love a tiny laptop. I'm not gonna lie. Love me. Oh, and see, I almost threw out her glasses. You got to be careful with, oh, and there's her earrings. You know, I saw somebody posted in the Doll Circle group on Facebook, and they asked, mine didn't come with earrings. Did I miss something? And the answer is, you missed nothing. They were in this tissue paper. And I was about to say, parents, be careful when the kids are opening up these tissue papers because they put really, really tiny things in here that get lost immediately when they fall out of the tissue paper. So yeah, so be really careful when opening them, especially if you have like pets or like babies or toddlers and presents are being opened. Be careful because there's lots of little stuff in these tissues that just gets completely lost. So the answer to the person in the Doll Circle group was, you lost them. And now we're going to open up the shoe box carefully with the tissue. And there's only shoes in the shoe box. And oh, what shoes they are. Oh, yes. Oh, yes. Oh, yeah. Yeah. You see, now you'll notice, and you may have wondered yesterday from the video, I love fashion dolls. I love fashion on dolls. I just don't like it on myself. No interest in wearing it, but I really love it. Like, I'm rewatching Gossip Girl right now. Oh my God, the clothes. Okay, so here we go. Here's our first outfit piece on our little hanger. Look at this beautiful fuzzy stole. Oh, it's like pink mink. Of course, it's faux fur because no human with a soul wears real fur. Sorry, gotta get political on you there. Look at this Louis Vuitton knockoff. I love it. Yes, I'm being very political. I just found out that this week in Denmark, 15 million minks, you know, the animal, were killed because they've developed a variant strain of the virus. So, of course, you know, we have to protect the humans. But my thought was, why are we still farming minks? Are we still making coats out of animals? Just asking for a friend. Okay, oops, the jacket. Oh, this jacket. Oh, I love this jacket so much. I just love her style so much. Okay. And so, of course, it's like, dress me. So I'm going to get her out of this packaging, and I will be right back. And she's out of the box. And I will say that she does have a tremendous amount of gel in her ponytail. I do not have the time to wash it and let it dry so that it will look awesome for this video, because that's just not how I film. But collectors, you'll definitely be wanting to do that. Parents, aunts, uncles, grandparents, etc. If you want to help your child with that, all you need is some warm water, and you can use some baby shampoo, or honestly, you can even use like dish detergent, but baby shampoo is the best. You just wash it, rinse it with warm water, just like don't get the head submerged and obviously the dew up here, just the hair that's all jelly, and it'll wash out really, really nicely. Just let it dry naturally and you should have some lovely waves and a much, much nicer looking hair than what I've got going on right here. But having said that, she's awesome. One of the things that's giving me flashback vibes. Come on, elbows, work with me. Come on. All right. So do you remember Superstar Barbie? One of the things that Superstar Barbie was a big deal to me. One of the things that absolutely rocked my world about Superstar Barbie was her ring. And this is giving me Superstar Barbie vibes. And of course, her nails are adorable. Her face, very sweet. Very, very sweet. I mean, obviously their faces very much look alike, but look at her beautiful lips. Her hair, though, is obviously, she's called Big Wig. Her hair is the story. And what I'm loving about this hair, other than, you know, the iridescence of it, is the color is a very unique pink. It is not Pepto-Bismol pink. It's not really rose gold, but there is some sort of like a rose gold-ish, yeah, you can see like a really crunchy feeling to it. And just look at all that hair. Look, I mean, that's hair right there. This one, I don't always, I mean, I very infrequently actually do the step of washing my doll's hair because I just don't have the energy to do that. You know, I gotta conserve my energy. But I'm loving her hair so much that I'm going to do that after this video. Oops, she's still got a plastic band on her. Now, this is her, the clothes that she came in. So these are her undergarments. I'm loving the pinstripe stockings. Oops. Loving the pinstripe stockings. I am feeling Wall Street immediately because, yes, this is how you slay. This is how you slay on Wall Street. I'm going to get her dressed very quickly here. Let's see, can we get your hands down into the jacket without having to take your hands off? I think we might be able to. It's a possibility. Nope. Yep, not. Don't lose the ring. Now, to remove their hands, you very gently squeeze at the wrist. Don't just yank on their hand because I've done that. And sometimes you just end up ripping off the hand and you can't put it back on. So parents, you know, teach your kids how to do that. People, if you're like concerned about, you know, kind of, I don't know, thinking that these dolls look risque or whatever, don't buy them. That's all I have to say about it. Kids really like them and adults who collect dolls love them. And, you know, I don't know. I don't know what more to say about that. Like, I don't really have an argument to change your mind. There's other dolls out there and, you know, by all means, please buy them. But, you know, there's a whole bunch of people who love these dolls and kids who love these dolls and parents who are okay with these dolls. So, you know, please don't take our dolls away. Now, this is really cool because her jacket, oh, that's awesome. Her jacket, this isn't Velcro. This is a little clear plastic snap here. So this is definitely going to stay closed right at the waist. So you get that beautiful silhouette. Look at this. Look at this. This is a look. I need her shoes on. Oh, this girl's taken on Wall Street. Yes, she is. You guys are taken on Wall Street and you are going to win. You're going to win. You will be the new wolves of Wall Street. Yes, you will. I'm trying to get her shoes. Getting the shoes on over the stockings is always a problem, but you know what? I don't care because I will take dealing with shoes going over stockings over painted on leggings any day. I've been looking at my Ever After High collection and I'm just like the painted on leggings when that started to happen and painted on pants. I was just like, ah! It was so heartbreaking for me. Okay.
So now, check it out with the shoes. Look at this with the shoes. Oh, oh my gosh, she's gorgeous. Now I've got to get this. I don't like the collar. I'm going to tell you right now. Oh, you know what? This sweater's really hot. The sweater that I'm wearing is uncomfortably warm. I don't think I'm going to do the collar. I will put it on for you guys, but I think in my world, in my display, she's not going to wear this collar. I don't like it. I think it's unnecessarily old boy sort of, you know, this is the way men dress, so we're gonna do this. You know what I'm saying? You picking up what I'm throwing down? All right, I'm trying to tuck her tie into her bustier, and it's just not working for me. There it is with the collar. Let me know what you think in the comments. And then her pink stole, does this just stretch or is there a snap? How does this work? I think this just, yeah, I think, guys, put it on from her legs up to get her beautiful stole on her. It's funny because we were talking about the mink thing last night. My husband and I were also talking about how, like, our generation did not do the whole fur coat thing, but, like, our mothers and our grandmothers did. And because they couldn't, you know, afford, I don't know. I don't like it with the stole. It looks good in the artwork, but the actual execution is not, it's not done for me. I'm taking it back off. They could afford a stole, and in my family's case, there was a mink stole that kind of, there were 9 sisters in my grandmother's family, and they had a mink stole that they all basically shared. So for special occasions, the mink stole would kind of, you know, it was kind of cool. 1 mink stole, 9 sisters. There she is with her glasses. So she looks, you know, very businesslike-y. You know, they're okay. I'm not going to keep them on her either. Let me put on her earrings that I lost so brilliantly. Okay. And here she is with her earrings in. I think she's adorable. I don't like the collar. You guys let me know what you think. Of course, you should flatten out the tie. And here she is with Madam Queen. She does come with a stand as well. She's really cool. She's really cool. So I'm very excited about her. I'm excited I got her first because she was the first, like, of all of them, she's the one I was most into aesthetically-wise. Aesthetically-wise? Is that even a word, Melissa? Aesthetically-wise, you know, aesthetically speaking. And there she is with her little sis. They're so cute. Oh, I dig it. And I dig that she's got the blue eyeshadow from the 60s and everything. I am loving her. So really, 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 I'm loving the outfit, loving the aesthetic. You guys let me know in the comment what you think. I love this peachy, rosy, goldy, but not rose gold hair with the light part, the blonde part of the hair is like a winter white, haha, winter chill, like almost, you know, like an ecru, but no, not ecru's too brown, but it's not pure white, you know, so it just, it goes so beautifully with the hair. Love it, love it, love it. We can do without the stole. Loving the laptop though. And let me know in the comments what you think, and I will see you guys again real soon, and don't forget about November 14th. Hope to see you there. Love you so much. Thank you for watching. Bye.